Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here, and I am glad you're here. I have been putting out videos for over 12 years, and I decided I was going to redo some of the videos so that you could know better ways to start and how to start and which ways to start. Because when I started, it was all hot dogs. I was broke as a convict. Didn't have a pot to piss in or a window to throw it out of, and it was just a struggle. I had to beg, borrow, steal, and sell two kids' kidneys just to get enough money to get a cart. And if you haven't seen those videos, you're welcome to go to them. You'll see them right here on YouTube. But what I did is, over the years, I've learned so many new ways that I could have done it easier, faster, and better. And so if you have, anywhere between 2 grand and 5 grand, sure, you can start a hot dog business real quick, okay, and start making money day one, especially with all the free content I've got out there to show you exactly what to do. And if you want to do that, what I'm going to put up is, if you go to learnhotdogs.com, it's right there on your screen, and you'll be able to start see the start to finish and how to do that instantly. And we've had vendors from the time they decided, hey, I'm going to get a hot dog cart, to the time they were on the street, 4 days and making money. Okay. And we've documented those. I've got videos of those vendors, interviews with those vendors where I've traveled to see them and visit them. So there's a lot of information and a lot of advice there. Here, I'm going to give you what would I have done in my situation had I known what I know now. And I would have picked something else, because I cover kettle corn, I cover lemonade businesses and shaved ice businesses and street corn businesses and mini donut businesses. And in fact, that mini donut business was the first thing I ever did street food. And I was about 9 or 10 when I did that, maybe 11. Okay. So, and I did it with my mom and dad, but my point is I did it and talked them into doing it. So I've got that stuff on here and I've got pictures of that. But my point is that there's so many different variables now, but where would I start if I didn't have the money? Like back when I started, I didn't have the money. Okay. The times that were bad, 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 right? And I had still had a bunch of kids at home, and they were spoiled, rotten, wanted to eat every single day. Okay. They're just spoiled. So I decided I'm going to get a cart and I'm going to go out. And well, it took me a couple, 3, 4 weeks to get all that done. And then get out and start making money. And so it still works. It works better now because I teach you better methods to do that. But let's say it was me or you, and you didn't have 3 grand to start, and you needed to get started now, today. You need something going. I would tell you to go to, and I'm going to put this up here. I created this website because it has a gob of different stuff, and it's legal ways for you to cook in your own dang kitchen. And I'm pointing to my kitchen, okay? And so you can start in your own dang kitchen and start making money immediately. Start making money immediately. I'm talking, you can cook some stuff today and make money tonight. That is just cool as heck to me. Had I known that, I wouldn't have had to sell two kids' kidneys, right? I could have just, and I'm kidding about that. Don't be sending me hate mail. So anyway, I wouldn't have had to sell everything we had and all our tools and everything. And I mean, we begged, borrowed, did everything we could to get the money to get our first hot dog cart. Well, had I known this, I could have started that day. I already love baking, and I didn't know that you could do that. Pretty much in all 50 states, you can do it. Well, all 50 states, you can do something. And I teach you what those somethings are in those states. In fact, I've broke it down by state. So what I do is give you the basic information and tell you how to do it. And then I'll show you, and all this information is free. And you'll just go in and pick the state you live in and go, okay, I can do that. And I'm going to do this, or I'm going to do this. And you can start making money. So if I had it all over to do it over again, I would go to kitcheninincome.com, take that information. I would have had a cart quicker. I would have had a food truck quicker, a food trailer quicker. All of it would have happened quicker for me had I known about Kitchen Income, because it covers so many things. Now, there's also some vendors, a lot of vendors that have started with lemonade. And I freaking love it because it is so easy to start with lemonade. Now, there's a little catch here. Not all states allow it. Okay? Not all states allow you to do lemonade, fresh squeezed lemonade, on a table out in front of people and do that. Okay. But many do, most do. So you can start a lemonade business for very cheap. Okay. Lemons and all, your equipment, your banner, even you could start for less than $500. But I didn't even have $500, but I still would have started with that before I would have started with hot dogs, because I didn't have the money for hot dogs, and hot dogs cost me about $5,000 to get started, $3,000 to $5,000. So, and it's still doable that way, but had I been able to start with $500, I would have been out in a week instead of a month vending. So howtostartalemonadebusiness.com. I have two broke sisters, okay, that were broke, and they needed to start, and they needed to make money. And they both had kids. And I said, here you go. Start with lemonade. This is what I do. I'd start with lemonade. Well, I tell their story there. You'll get to see them, pictures of them, doing their thing in North Carolina, in the mountains, doing their thing with the lemonade immediately. So they decided to do it. And 2 days later, they were doing it. And they were making money. So you can do the same thing. So it's all doable. But maybe you don't have $500. You don't want to wait. Then you go back to kitchen income and do kitchen income and do it legally, because it's legal. And I'll tell you what rules you have to follow to make that happen. Okay. Now, so if you want to start with something bigger up front, don't want to be in your kitchen, maybe you don't have a kitchen and you want to start doing lemonade, you can start on a thrifty budget, shoestring type budget. So that's a great way to start. And literally, depending on where you set up your locations, which I teach all that here too, is you can go in and start doing lemonade and start doing all that stuff immediately. And you will be making good money, like replace your income money. Okay. One of my good friends does lemonade. I got another friend that does lemonade right down the street. And I've interviewed these people. You've seen them. If you watch any of the videos, if you go to YouTube and go to my page and search lemonade, you're going to see these videos and you're going to see the interviews and you're going to go, well, if they can do it, I can do it. Of course, if you can squeeze a handle and make some lemonade, you can make money. How much are they making? Well, it cost about $1.50. It used to be about $1. Now with inflation and stuff, it's about $1.50 a cup, maybe even $2 in some areas, like out west, it's about $2 a cup to make. But they're selling them for $6, $7, and $8 a cup. And you go, oh my gosh, they won't pay that here. I promise they will. I'll cover that later. Okay. Now, what's the next thing? Kettle corn. Let's say you want to spend some money on kettle corn. Well, I'll show you how to do that with the kitchen income without spending $5,000 on a kettle maker. Okay. I interviewed, and I have multiple times, and I have articles from this feller and his wife, okay, how they do popcorn and kettle corn from their house legally, okay? And you can too. Interviewed a feller in Jacksonville, Florida, North Florida, right outside of Jacksonville city limits, but it's still city limits because the whole county is the city. And he started selling it to bait shops. He was broke when he came to me. And he started bagging it at home, had a little thing in his garage, making it, bagging it legally. Okay, legally. So you can do that too. So learnkettlecorn.com is another one. But first I would tell you, if you're going to do it on a budget and you're not going to go spend $5,000 on a kettle corn machine, then definitely just do it through kitchen income. That'll be easier. Okay, you can do that right on your stovetop and we'll show you how. Okay, so those are the ones I wanted to share. Those are the ones I wanted to, for you to know about how to get going. I'm going to teach you some other stuff and I'm going to share with you some other things that may inspire new ideas in you. But all of this is so that you can get started with little to no money. Okay. If you want to. And many people come to this business. Like I never grew up going, you know what? I'm going to be a hot dog vendor when I grow up. I never even thought about being a hot dog vendor ever. And then it wasn't until I lost everything and my kids are now on food stamps. We're all on food stamps and we don't have nothing that I heard about another family that saved their house out of foreclosure with a hot dog cart in Texas or New Mexico. I think it was Texas. Anyway, it's been a long time and I've slept since then. They saved their home. And I said, well, crap, it's too late for me to save my home, but I can get started and start making money. And I did. And within a year, I had 22 carts running Wouldn't advise that to anyone unless you're missing a brain. Okay. I apparently was missing a brain and decided that was a good idea. It wasn't. Okay. 2-3 carts, great. 22 carts, not so great. Anyway, I love you and I'm here to help you. Please leave your comment below. If you're on YouTube, leave it there. If you're not on YouTube and you saw me on Facebook or somewhere else, you can email me. Okay. And I try to answer everybody's email, but it's ben@vendorsunited.com. ben@vendorsunited.com will come to me and I will help you. I'll try to answer your question. Oftentimes you'll see I'll put up a link to an article where I already covered it, but either way, thank you for being here. Love you. See you soon. Bye.